Good morning and welcome to the late early morning show with Ahana Sur. Today, we have a very special guest joining us. After years and years of trying to find out what makes him tick, we have evidence of Mr. Carbon Monoxide living his true life thanks to our year-long sting operation.
Hi, I'm Carbon Monoxide. I have no scent, no color, and you can barely feel my presence, which is why people hardly ever notice me. I rarely ever stay at home, but when I do, it's bad. My presence is so unbearable that people start vomiting, fainting, going dizzy, or even unconscious. Those who can't stand me at all may die, but that's only if I stay in too long. I'm also found around gas stoves or leaking chimneys in the house, and that's when people really notice me, but then they make me leave. My favorite place to be is factories, and that's where I find more people like me. I also like to stay near vehicles on the road, but they're always moving, so it's tough to keep up with them, but when I do, I never let go. On special occasions, I burst crackers with everyone. But sometimes whenever I burst too many crackers, people soon fall sick or get injured, and then I'm banned from meeting them ever again. Whenever I feel adventurous, I explore active volcanoes and sometimes even fires. But these always result in people getting rid of me by spraying me with water or running away to a different city.
My forest walks almost always end up with a forest fire. It's so warm and cozy, I spread out everywhere so that I can share the fire with everyone. But again, they shoot me down with tons and tons of water. Sometimes there's even news coverage, but my name is never mentioned and I never get any credit.
Only when I stay at home do people pay attention to me. But I threaten their oxygen supply to their brain and heart if I stay home too long. And then they're rushed to the hospital. I'm not allowed to meet them because I might kill them. I mean, I've only killed a few hundred people every year and suddenly I'm not allowed to meet them. One day, I got extremely upset and I started hurting people all over the world. I created multiple forest fires, I stayed in closed areas way too long, and I burst too many crackers. This resulted in nearly a fourth of the world's population in hospitals, fighting various diseases and death. After that day, I was taken a lot more seriously. Once they learned more about me, they started monitoring me everywhere I went and kept records of my whereabouts. Slowly, people started finding out all my weak spots. They started getting their car exhausts and engines checked regularly. People started to carpool, which meant fewer cars for me to hang around. There was also a decrease in factories, which meant fewer hangout spots for my friends and I. No one would burst any crackers, and everyone started to light candles on special occasions. People started to grow more trees and keep plants at homes and offices. But I'm allergic to nature. People stopped mistreating me and started taking me seriously. That's when I was found around less. I lost nearly all my strength and was unable to go anywhere. Now that people have slowly started to forget about who I am, I've started to gain more strength. People will soon remember who I am, but it will have been too late by then. I will have been king of the world with no power strong enough to stop me.
So, now you know the scary truth of Mr. Carbon Monoxide. Beware, fellow viewers, if we do not take him seriously, he may end up doing serious damage to our country, or even worse, to the world. Statistics show that 20,000 to 30,000 people are sickened due to accidental carbon monoxide poisoning, and approximately 100 to 500 die of it. I say that it's up to us now, whether we want carbon monoxide to have us live in fear, or we triumph him and have him live in fear. Just something to think about. This is Ahana Sur, signing out.